The Big Lebowski moseyed its way into theaters in 1998. While it wasn't a giant success at the time, the Coen Brothers' seventh feature got its legs after its release and is now the epitome of a cult classic. With a passionate fanbase known as Achievers,
yeah, the Achievers,
the film is a staple for midnight screenings and remains highly quotable to this day.
No, I do mind. The dude minds. This will not stand, you know? This aggression will not stand, man.
The Big Lebowski is frequently referenced in pop culture.
They did in the Big Lebowski. I love the Big Lebowski.
And apparently, it even exists in the Marvel Cinematic Universe.
This guy makes Captain America look like the dude. The Big Lebowski.
Which is actually kind of confusing when you think about it. So how has one of the Coens' most beloved yet divisive films managed to stay relevant for so many years?
Obviously, you're not a golfer.
Well, one reason is surely the film's uniqueness. If someone were to say that a film features memorable performances from Jeff Bridges, John Goodman, Steve Buscemi, John Turturro, Julianne Moore, and Philip Seymour Hoffman, it would likely sound like a prestige drama. But The Big Lebowski is actually rather hard to define. The film is an interesting case of genre fusion. As much as it's a stoner comedy, it also has elements of film noir and even westerns, in addition to a heavy dose of absolute absurdity. On paper, this film should not work. We have an aging hippie with an affinity for white Russians, a volatile Vietnam veteran, a seemingly meaningless and convoluted scheme, a cowboy narrator, and a whole lot of bowling. Seems like a rather hard sell. It's easy for many to overlook the film as a work of art due to its ridiculous nature and non-stop jokes.
Good night, sweet prince.
But The Big Lebowski is still a Coen Brothers film. So you know there's plenty of artistry and likely a lot of subtext. Or is there? Interpretations of the film's true meaning range from religion to politics, but many believe that there simply is no deeper meaning. That the film is just the Coens having fun playing with genre and our expectations. That any sort of analysis would be counterproductive and a contradiction of the dude himself. Either way, it's these many strange yet beloved elements that have made the film so fun to endlessly discuss. Secondly, the Coens themselves have contributed to the lasting legacy of The Big Lebowski. It's no secret that the internet loves the Coen brothers. And even if you have Coen fatigue, you can't deny that they're a fun topic. With an extensive filmography spanning multiple genres, Joel and Ethan Coen may have the best body of work for debating. Naming the best Coen brothers film is sure to ignite a heated argument.
You're here to rent The Big Lebowski?
It's the best Coen brothers movie ever.
Best Coen brothers comedy.
Aren't they all?
There's those who take the more obvious route and say that their best film is the best picture winning No Country for Old Men. Others go with something more esoteric like A Serious Man. But certainly a whole lot of people are going to choose the classics. Something like Raising Arizona, Fargo, and of course, The Big Lebowski. As cherished as The Big Lebowski is, it's actually rather divisive, especially amongst Coen Brothers fans. Those who rank it highly view it as an essential Coens film, one that combines everything the filmmakers do best. And those who dismiss it find it to be hollow, bizarre, and ultimately unrewarding. But no matter how you feel about the film,
you know, that's just like your opinion, man.
The fact that the Coens are so respected within the film community has allowed many of their films to stay somewhat relevant, but none come close to the endurance of The Big Lebowski. So there obviously has to be a bit more to the film's legacy, and that is most definitely its overwhelming cultural impact. Despite predating internet trends, The Big Lebowski's presence has been strengthened by the internet. Various viral memes have allowed the film to stay current and find a younger audience.
Am I the only one around here who gives a shit about the rules?
Nobody f**ks with the Jesus.
But the cultural impact of The Big Lebowski spans far beyond the internet. Forget about merchandise and homages. The Big Lebowski inspired its own annual festival.
Lebowski Fest. It's a two-day festival where fans dress up as the characters in the movie and they go bowling and there's parties and they watch the movie.
The film even inspired its own religion called Dudism, which has over 450,000 ordained followers.
It's basically modern Taoism. It's this idea that there is a harmonious way to live your life. There is a good way to live, you know, a life-affirming way to live.
The Big Lebowski is a rare example of a film that doesn't just endure, but grows stronger with time. Its impact is so enormous that it's no longer simply a film. It's a way of life.
Yeah, well, the dude abides.